Hey there and welcome back. In today's video, I'll be going over the battle axe and showcase can be used for different content. The battle axe is very versatile and thrives in both PvE and PvP. With the new EU server right around the corner, I want to take the time to provide you with a viable build that you can start off with. If you're new to the game or have been interested in trying out the battle axe for some time, make sure to watch to the end of the video. We will talk about what items to take, which abilities to use, and what content the builds thrive on. Now, before we get into the video, make sure to join the Discord community. We have players from all regions. If you're a solo player and looking to group up or have any questions, make sure to join. I run 30-day premium giveaways every 2 weeks and currently have a giveaway going for an EU server founder pack. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Now, without further ado, let's get into the first build, which is the cheap build. This build does well in both PvE and PvP. You will easily kill mobs out in the open world, clear solo dungeons, and win 1v1s with enough IP. You can do well against elite mobs in the black zones and in the roads. If you're planning on heading out to the roads to clear these elite mobs, I do recommend at least 1150 to 1200 IP. Alright, so let's talk about the build. So, of course, the first item that we're going to start off with here is the battle axe, because all builds will share this throughout. Now, with the battle axe, I'm recommending like a 4.2 for the cheap build, because it is on the cheaper end. You won't benefit from some of the higher tier Q abilities or your first ability until later on once you get into a more intermediate or advanced build. But in the meantime, this definitely should get you through. Now, for your Q ability, what you're going to want to take for single target, you can go with Rending Strike. Rending Strike does physical damage and will apply a bleed to your enemy that stacks up to 3 times. And once you reach the maximum amount of stacks, it'll go ahead and affect the healing received by 12% for 5 seconds. If you are AoEing mobs down or wanting to hit more than one, definitely recommend going with Rending Strike, as it does a AoE ability. As you can see here, that's the one I'm using right now. It'll go ahead and hit multiple targets and providing multiple bleeds. So it's a really good ability to have when fighting multiple mobs. It also applies the healing debuff once you hit the 3 stacks on that mob. Now for your second ability, or your W if you're playing on PC, you're going to want to go with Adrenaline Boost, which releases an adrenaline boost increasing all of your damage by 25%. Your movement speed by 40%, and your auto attack speed by 40% for up to 7 seconds. Now, if you don't deal direct damage for 3.5 seconds, the adrenaline boost will end early. So pretty much this is the way it looks. You can use it to either chase people down, or if you want to go ahead and start attacking, it allows you to attack faster and run faster. So as long as you keep attacking, it'll go and stay up for those full 7 seconds, which is definitely beneficial. Now, the next ability here is your E, which is your third ability, Blood Bandit. Now, Blood Bandit has 2 different possibilities, as it has 2 charges or 2 combo attacks to it. So the first one is called Blood Draw. You'll throw an axe directly dealing physical damage to all the enemies that it hits. And based on the number of bleeds that they have, those rendering bleeds on them, it'll do more damage. So for example, if it has no bleeds on them, it'll do about 591 damage, 1 bleed, 675, 275, and 3844, and so on. The second throw is called Blood Bandit. Now, the second throw, what it does, it also does physical damage, but it'll also heal you based on the amount of charges the first enemy that you hit. So let's kind of take a look at this here. We're going to put some bleeds up. Now, you're going to have your first one hits all 3. As you can see, you have your second charge, and if you throw it again, it'll go ahead and do more damage and heal you. Now, the cool thing about this is that you don't have to use the second axe throw unless you really need it, either to finish somebody off or if you need that sustain. Now, if you don't throw the axe, what happens, it has a shorter cooldown and you can throw the first axe again. So kind of keep that in mind as you're playing. Now, as far as your passive goes, I recommend Deep Cuts. For every 4 auto attacks, it'll inflict a bleed based on the damage that you deal for 1.5 seconds. So really good here. Now, for the cheap build for your helmet, I do recommend the Hunter Hood. I'm right now sporting the 6.1, which gets me to about tier 7. But you don't necessarily need to start with something this expensive. You can get something cheaper. The good thing about this hood is that it is really cheap. It's good for PvE and PvP. So as you see here, for the first ability, I'm using Retaliate. Now, Retaliate, what it does, it creates a magic barrier around you, increasing your resistances by 59 for 3 seconds. And it reflects 85% of incoming damage as magical damage. So as you can see here, if you're taking damage either from a mob or from an enemy, just hit and you'll see it pop up for you. And you know that you're reflecting. I definitely recommend trying to time this properly, either when an enemy jumps on you and does all their burst, or if you see like a fire mage loading up a big fireball, you want to make sure that you pop that at the right time. Now, the next ability that you're going to take here for the Hunter Hood is Balanced Mind. Balanced Mind will increase your damage and your healing cast by 1.5%. and it also increases your defense. So just a little bit more sustain, a little bit more damage and defense. Now, the next thing here is your jacket. So your armor piece is going to be the mercenary jacket. Now, the mercenary jacket's great because it provides bloodlust, which will heal you for the next 6 seconds up to 7 times. So what you want to do here is if you see that you need some sort of sustain, you'll go ahead and pop your bloodlust. You can start auto attacking and you'll see that you're healing yourself. Now, you can want to pair this up with other abilities that give you faster attack speed. That way you can go ahead and get those attacks out as fast as possible and increase your sustain. So the amount of sustain that comes from this build is what kind of helps you out with those bigger mobs, elite mobs, as well as against any sort of PvP. You'll have your sustain from your axe and as well from your bloodlust. Now, the other ability, once again, is going to be balanced mind for the passive on mercenary jacket, which increases all of your damage and healing by 4% and your defense by about 2%. So just a little bit more sustain, a little bit more damage, which is great. Now, as far as your offhand goes, I recommend starting off with the torch. The reason why, it's because your cooldown rate is increased, meaning that you'll be able to go ahead and get more abilities out and either provide more damage or more sustain. And on top of that, you also get an increased auto attack speed. So auto attacking is key here for you, especially when you're trying to sustain and keep your bleeds up. You'll be able to maximize your amount of damage. Now, for your boots, I do recommend going with the Adept Soldier Boots. Now, the Adept Soldier Boots is a tier 4 boot. You can get 4.1, 4.2, whichever you like. For your F ability, which is your first ability here, it's going to be Rejuvenating Sprint, which increases your movement speed by 80% and as well as your healing. So as you see here, you'll pop that if you want to catch somebody, run away. I recommend holding on to boots as much as you can, especially in PvP scenarios. Usually the first person to use their boots is the person that either loses or can't catch anybody, right? So you just want to make sure that you hold that as much as you can to be able to close the gap on your enemy. So the next ability is going to be Toughness, which increases your defense by 2.5%, just making you a little bit more tanky. So from what you've seen from this build so far, has a lot of sustain, has fast attacks, it has a lot of damage, and it increases your defense. Now, as far as your cape goes, you can go with a basic cape, especially if you're starting the game on the new server. There's not going to be a lot of capes available. You can try to get it up to 4.3 by transmuting at the start. All it does pretty much is provide you with a little bit more energy as well as energy regeneration. Poison potions do a good amount of damage as far as true damage goes versus players, and as well as true damage versus mobs. Also, when you have your enemy poisoned, they will be slowed by 15% with any sort of auto attacks that you do. So it's a good way to kind of slow them down and keep on them. For your food, I do recommend roast pork, especially in PvE scenarios. The more damage that you do, the more you'll heal yourself with its meat roast. Whenever you deal damage, you'll steal 9.45% of the health the enemy has lost in the next 30 minutes. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to hit the like button, comment a weapon you would like for me to break down, and subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to join the Discord community and partake in the giveaways. Like always, stay epic, stay legendary, and I'll see you in the next one.